On Game Show Network, anyone can win terrific prizes like this. Enjoy beautiful floors for life with Pickering Laminate Flooring in elegant colors and patterns with coordinating vents and moldings. Made in America by Pickering.
What's My Line panel. First, our own Olympic laugh-getter, Soupy Sales.
Thank you, and thank you, Chet Gould. Right now, here's a young lady that you see so many times on Petticoat Junction and My Three Sons and a host of other shows. Would you please say hello to Meredith McCrae?
Soupy. Our next guest is now an official resident of Toronto, but he flies in all the time to New York to be with us on this show, Mr. Henry Morgan.
Thank you very much. And then the great theater marquee lights up, and it says, Arlene the Great Francis. Oh.
How can I follow that? Well, Tuesday is our good news day, and here is the headline. Larry Blyden succeeds.
Well, hello, everybody. Gemini is rising today, and it promises to be a nice day.
Right.
Are you all well?
Yes.
We have marvelous challengers and a very interesting program today, actually,
we'll
which you will probably enjoy. Would our first challenger now enter and sign in, please, and we'll begin. Felipe Rojas Lombardi. You almost ran out of board there. Where are
almost,
you from?
Yes, from Lima, Peru.
All right.
I live in New York already for many years, and I consider myself New York, and I love it here.
Oh, good. Okay, Mr. Lombardi is an authority on the culinary arts. He is a cooking teacher. He writes a cooking column, which is syndicated throughout the country. He's written several cookbooks. This is his latest effort. As you see, it's called Felipe Rojas Lombardi Teaches George Plimpton His Game Cookery Recipes. And it's more than a book, because in addition to a text, it has these tapes that you play. And what's on the tapes, Felipe?
Well, it's actually the instructions about the recipes, each one we have in the book inside.
Okay. Now, all of this is fascinating, but it's not why he's here. He is here because he has a particular food which he considers his specialty, and we will now show the audience what that food is. And we'll start the questioning with Arlene Francis.
Well, I'll tell you something, Mr. Lombardi. If you've cooked it in the studio, I can smell it, and it smells terrific. Did you cook a little of it in the studio? Is there some of it around?
No, I didn't cook it.
One down and nine to go.
Well, you wouldn't call that a question. Now, come on.
Well, you... Huh? No, did you mean that as a question, or were you just messing around?
No, I did. Everybody can smell it. Can't everybody?
No.
Oh, terrific. Well, all right. Is it a highly spiced dish?
Not really.
One down and nine. Well, we're right back where we started. Yeah. One down and nine to go. Zuppi?
Well, is it anything in the... when you cook it, does it contain meat of some kind?
Well, I will not call that. No, really.
Shh, don't help him. He's very smart. Two down and eight to go. Meredith?
Yes. Would what your specialty is, would it be served as a main course?
Usually, no.
Three down and seven to go, Henry.
Well, this would be a snap question. Is it vegetable?
No.
Four down and six to go, Arlene.
Does it contain any pasta?
No.
Five down and five to go, Soupy.
Well, it sure smells like onions, doesn't it?
Yeah.
It smells like onions. Are there onions in what you're cooking?
He's not cooking anything.
I don't smell anything.
You don't smell anything?
No.
No. Zuby?
It's just a camouflage.
It's a commissary downstairs.
It's a commissary downstairs.
Or else I'm on my eighth day. Anyway.
They okay. have an onion spray.
Yeah.
When we were using that.
Zuby? You want to ask a question? Don't kid me.
No, I'd really like to have a drink, but, oh, yes, getting back to the thing. Now, this dish, it isn't a main dish. It isn't a main dish that you use it for. Is it served on a plate?
Yes.
Okay. That's right. It's not in a bowl. That's right. It's on a plate. And it has no meat in it?
No.
That's correct. It has no meat in it.
It has no meat in it. And it isn't any vegetables, because Henry asked that. Short naps are great. I pass. I don't.
Okay, Meredith?
Okay, it doesn't have any meat. How about fish? Is part of it fish?
Yes.
Is it an unusual type of fish that we would ordinarily not have?
Possibly.
I mean, as opposed
yes.
to like trout and sole.
It's unusual,
okay.
right?
Is it eel?
No.
No.
Six down and four to go. Henry.
Is it a big fish?
Can be very big, yes.
About 15 seconds?
Don't worry, but I'm measuring fish. Let's see. Medium fish and it could be a big fish. And, of course, a whale's
it's
a mammal,
fish that
right?
sometimes is large, but it isn't necessarily...
Not necessarily large. Like a tuna is pretty big, right?
Mm-hmm. You're all assuming that it is a fish.
He said it was a fish.
He said, is it fish, was the question
oh,
he was asked.
Oh, is it a bouillabaisse, mixed?
A bouillabaisse. Seven down and three to go, Arlene.
Are there, is there more than a fish in whatever it is that you have contrived? Something else besides fish?
Something
Boy, that's
else?
Hard to answer.
Yes, it is hard.
There's
is
nothing
it?
Besides fish product.
It's a
that?
Product well, of fish, yes.
Is it? Does it have anything to do with the eggs of a fish, the roe of a fish?
Yes.
Yes.
It isn't caviar.
Caviar!
Oh, where is it?
Very good, panel. That's hard to get to. Very good. That's terrific, panel. Yeah. That's very hard to get to. What is caviar, actually? It's a roe of fish, isn't it?
Well, it's the eggs of the Asturian. Usually you call caviar out to Russia. In Russia, they call Ikrar. Uh-huh. I-K-R-A. Yes.
How many kinds of caviar are there?
You have six kinds of caviar. You have the queen of the caviar, who is the beluga. Mm-hmm. You have the Ocentoba, who is quite good qualities of caviar. You have the small eggs, who is the Ceruga caviar. Mm-hmm. Also, you have the gray caviar, who the color is very identified. Mm-hmm. And surprisingly enough, you have the pressed caviar, mm-hmm. who many people will like it very much. And it's have a good flavor. We don't forget also about the salmon caviar, who red is the caviar. Red caviar.
Why is it so expensive?
Well, it's expensive because you cannot produce it that much. The Asturian doesn't produce that much.
Okay, then
and
when
also
he says Asturian, it's his pronunciation of the word sturgeon.
Sturgeon, okay. I'm sorry. And also, it's a lot of labor involved. And have to be packed special for each country. Mm. Like for Europe, they have packed with borax for preserve it. For United States, it's with salt. Certainly, you call many times unsalty caviar. It's not such a thing. It's always have a little amount of salt. And they call monosol.
Panel, I don't imagine you four gourmets would object if we tested your caviar IQ.
Oh,
would you?
Wait.
So through the courtesy of a celebrated Romanov caviar company, here is your problem for the day. Jennifer? Now, panel, stay there for a minute while I explain what happens. Here are three different kinds of caviar and a little champagne to cleanse the taste buds between each taste. Now, as you see, one of them costs $40 a pound, one $70 a pound, and one $100 a pound. That's expensive. Now, your idea is to taste it and then put each one in front of the cards, in front of their numbered, one, two, three, each plate. So put, if you think one is the most expensive one, put it in front of $100. If you think it's the least, put it in $40
no,
and so
I can't
on.
Wait any longer.
Okay, on your mark, get set, go. And we'll find out, excuse me. Now we're going to find out who knows what.
see.
This is 49 cents a gallon.
So Arlene is making...
Oh, God, it's wonderful. I got to taste the others.
Okay, now where do you want to put that one?
I want to put it either there or there. There, I think.
You want to put it
I
here?
I can't decide till I have all three.
Okay, you're putting it there. Henry, are you happy?
I'm hey. 21 again.
No names, please?
Yeah, yum, yum, yum.
Okay,
Yum, yum, yum.
Meredith, you pick.
I may switch. I want to taste all three first.
Yeah.
I have some stuck on my teeth, too, right?
Okay, but it's only a half-hour show, so if we could push it along a little bit, it would help. Okay.
Well, why ain't the band playing? Oh.
I don't eat $40 coffee.
What are we doing now? We have them all arranged, except Soupy hasn't put his down there yet.
Yes, I'm going to put mine down right now. You're the best and worst.
Okay, he has picked three is where? Three. Here he comes with the next one. He's putting one in the middle, and he's putting two on the end. So Soupy has 213. Meredith has 132. Henry has 213 also, and Arlene has 213. What is the correct sequence?
Well, the
this
correct
should be there.
The correct sequence is no. The $100 is fine for the number two. This is the beluga, actually the large eggs. Now we have here the ceruga, who is actually good qualities of caviar, but it's the small eggs. And here we have the fresh caviar, who is a combination of the ceruga, sometimes with the beluga, sometimes with the sultora.
That really, well, how much
so
is
this
one?
Right? So it's right, isn't
so
it? 213,
right.
Is that correct?
It's correct
oh.
here.
So
I
everybody's
can't...
right but Meredith, isn't that marvelous? Meredith, I'm sorry.
That's fantastic. And thank you for being with us on What's My Line.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
We'll be right back.
You trade your rookie Wink Martindale for my 1979 Gene Rayburn Attacks.
Oh, you're nuts. Look at how thick Wink's hair is.
Oh, I gotta get a young Wink.
Trade you for your Phil Stiller Burp.
Yeah, right. Why don't you just rip my beating heart out?
Oh, Wink's gonna go back in my pocket.
No, 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 wait. I'll give you my 98 Bob Eubanks gag.
There's no such thing as a 98 Banks.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Relive your favorite game show moments with the two best friends a fan ever had. Game shows, it's their life. Saturday, 8:30 Eastern, 5:30 Pacific, only on Game Show Network.
It never fails. If I spend money on something, the cats hate it. If it's free, they think it's wonderful. Bought the fancy bed. Whop. Free box it came in. Big hit. Wacky mouse. Flop. Ball of aluminum foil. Free, so big hit. So I knew my cats would love this fun play center. Why? I got it free, just for using my first USA Cat Lovers Platinum MasterCard.
Let the world know you love cats with the first USA Cat Lovers Platinum MasterCard. And if you call right now, you'll get this Cat Play Center, a $39 value, free with your first purchase or balance transfer. The first USA Cat Lovers Platinum MasterCard is like a reward for your good credit. There's no annual fee and a low introductory interest rate of 3.9% that goes up to just 12.99% after 6 months. Plus, you can choose from three charming cat designs.
Don't tell them, but I picked the one with the white cat.
You get all the privileges that come with a Platinum MasterCard, like our special warranty program for those high ticket purchases, lost luggage protection, even airline flight insurance. And every time you use it, you let everyone know you're a cat lover.
Now shopping is even more fun.
With our low introductory rate of 3.9%, you can transfer balances from your high rate cards to your Cat Lover's Platinum MasterCard and save hundreds of dollars in interest. Think of what you could do with all that extra money.
Well, now that they've got the play center and my belt, I guess they don't need any more toys.
Don't forget, you get the Cat Play Center with your first purchase or balance transfer. So call and apply today.
Call 1-800-773-2270 to apply for a first USA Cat Lovers Platinum MasterCard and get this Fun Cat Play Center, a $39 value, free with your first purchase or balance transfer. So call 1-800-773-2270.
Proper diet and exercise, Craftmatic beds help your body feel better. For watching TV, reading, sewing, or just putting your feet up and relaxing, you can't beat a Craftmatic adjustable bed. Yet, Craftmatic Model 2 beds are inexpensive. Call toll-free to get free information by mail about Craftmatic. Call for this important information now.
Call toll-free 1-800-847-9911.
Thank you, Chet. Meredith, you mustn't feel bad. These are all city people, and in Petticoat Junction, they don't know about fancy fishing.
That's
okay,
right,
would our next challenger enter and sign in, please?
Okay. Susan Law and Jean Reed. How are you, Interstellar? Where are you from?
We're from Sarasota, Florida.
Sarasota, Florida. Okay, panel, Jean Reed and Susan Narr work together at the same job. It is a job normally held by a man. We will now show the audience what their line is. And we'll start the questioning with Henry Morgan.
Jean... Do you do this on land?
Yes.
Does it have any connection with water?
No.
One down and nine to go, Arlene.
Do you, this is a service of some kind?
Yes.
Do you touch anyone when you are performing this service? Either one of you?
No.
No?
Two down and eight to go, Soupy.
Is what you do, is it ever, is it done inside most of the time?
Yes.
Is it ever inside? Do you ever, would you wear something, or rather, I mean, other than what you wear now in this job?
We could.
But it isn't necessary.
No.
But it isn't necessary.
No. Three down and seven to go, Meredith.
It's a service, so that is as opposed to entertainment, let's say, right?
Service.
No, not necessarily.
It's not as opposed to entertainment.
As opposed to a product, but not as opposed
to... Oh, all right, then I'll ask that. Would this be considered any form of entertainment in the sense that people might watch you do what you do?
I wouldn't think so.
No.
Four down and six to go, Henry. They could, but in their situation, they don't. It isn't something you would generally consider an entertaining thing to watch.
Okay.
Sorry about that. Henry?
I am too.
Niall, that leads into this question. Do people just... do people pay? Well, say, the people come to you and pay you for this service.
Well, we get paid for doing it, but they... No.
No,
no, not really.
No.
Five down and five to go, Arlene.
Do you work for a profit-making organization?
Yes.
Do you have anything whatsoever to do with any of the activity that takes place in Sarasota? By that I mean that there are the circuses there in the winter sometime.
Like, does anybody want to take a quick guess?
Ball game.
The general field of entertainment. You did kind of establish that. Now, do you want?
No,
to...
we didn't.
Well, is it, are you ever underwater when you do this?
No, we don't.
No.
That's something to do with men. You said as opposed to women. Does it have anything to do with, like, lifting weights or anything like that?
No, I tell you, we're about out of time. We're going to throw
acrobatics?
Them all over. They are television cameramen. Gene Reed and Susan Narr work at the UHF station WXLT-TV in Sarasota, Florida. And there is a picture. Can you get a shot of this, Lloyd? Of them doing it. There they are with their cameras. Okay, now, Gene, how did you and Susie happen to end up working together?
The one live show that we have on at WXLT happens to be at 9:30 in the morning. And the men, cameramen, had a little static about that, you know, getting up that early, because they're used to working nights. So we said, we will do it.
Were you already at the studio?
We were at the station doing other work at the time, and they said, fine, if you want to try, and they trained us a bit, and we took over, and now we're the best ones they've got.
That's no surprise. What show is it that you do in the morning?
Well, it's a live called Guy Pascal TV Talk.
Guy Pascal was on this show.
Yeah. He was on here.
Yeah.
He knows you.
For Pete's sake, it looks like very heavy equipment.
Well, it is heavy. Susie managed to run over the cable one day and get the camera back off it all on her own. Nobody never knows how she'd do that. And on our show, we don't have any rehearsal or anything. I was telling somebody here, we have things like... Guy will walk in and say, we've got a couple of singers, I think, if they show up, and like 30 will show.
Gentlemen, the next one of you that can't get the cable over, get the camera over the cable, we got a replacement for you right here. Thank you very much for being with us all. Thank you.
Morning seems so much brighter after a good night's sleep.
That's why I love my Tylenol PM. Sometimes I have trouble sleeping. I used to worry about taking something. How would I feel in the morning? And then I tried Tylenol PM. It stops my pain and helps me sleep. So in the morning, I'm rested, refreshed, ready to make the most of my day.
Rest easy. It's Tylenol PM.
Food that sounds as fresh as this comes from a food storage bag that sounds like this. Slide lock from Ziploc. The bag that tells you it's closed. So now you can be sure it's fresh because you can hear slide lock close. Slide lock. The zip locks in freshness from Ziploc.
Today, at any age, you might qualify for Medicare reimbursement and not even know it. If you or someone you know suffers from arthritis, multiple sclerosis, stroke, or any condition that prevents you from walking, and you're covered by private insurance or Medicare Part B, you could receive this new Rascal Power Chair with no out-of-pocket expense. To pre-qualify for Medicare and private insurance, call for this free application packet and color catalog. There's no purchase necessary. At no cost to you, Electric Mobility will process your paperwork within 24 hours. Your Rascal Power Chair won the 1998 Gold Award for Best New Product Design. You'll zip around tight corners and go anywhere independently. So if you're stuck at home, call for this free reimbursement packet. You have nothing to lose. Imagine this fabulous new product could be yours with little or no out-of-pocket expense if you call right now.
To see if you qualify, call 1-800-227-1188. That's 1-800-227-1188. Call now.
Okay, we're back, and it's time for the special feature of What's My Line? The appearance of our mystery guest. Are your blindfolds all in place, panel? Then would our mystery guest enter and sign in, please? Okay, panel, you have roughly 2 minutes. We'll go one question at a time, and we'll start with Meredith McRae.
Mystery guest, are you in the entertainment industry?
I have been for many years.
Henry?
I'm sorry about what happened, but...
It's still happening.
Are you in television?
Yes, sir.
Arlene?
Do you appear as a performer on a series?
Oh, you can call it a series.
Okay, Soupy?
Is it on at night?
No, sorry.
Meredith?
Is it a situation comedy series?
Sometime we think it is.
But the generic term, probably you would get a no. Henry?
Well, is it a regular dramatic show?
Sometimes we think that too.
But actually, you've gotten another no, Arlene.
Well, then is it a kind of a news show?
No, it isn't.
All right, for you.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Well, is it one of those daytime serials?
No.
Meredith?
Is it a variety show?
No.
What other shows are
Henry?
That?
Is there any information comes out of your show?
Oh, yes, lots.
Arlene?
Is it a game show?
You know it.
Soupy?
Oh, well, is it on NBC?
Yes, it is.
Meredith?
I'm going to make a stab at it. Is it Joe Garagiola?
That really is a stab, but it's wrong.
Henry?
That's a funny name for a game, Meredith. Is it on early in the day?
Yes, I would presume it is.
Arlene?
What's on early in the day? Concentration?
No.
Soupy?
Are you Bill Fleming?
No.
No, he's not Bill Fleming, you klutz. He's Art Fleming.
Art Fleming.
Thanks a lot,
that's
Bill Fleming.
That's who I meant. That's your brother.
No. There are five Flemings, none are related.
I know vegetable sales, don't you?
Yeah.
I know, that's who it was. I knew.
Thanks a lot.
You've been on for 10 years now.
Well, we are ending our ninth year. We start our 10th
next
month.
You're starting the 10th. That's an incredible record
lifetime.
For a network show.
It is. It's a fun show to do, I'm glad I'm the MC and not the contestant.
It's really, do people ever get really messed up on that show with what is?
Oh, yes, constantly. instantly. I do, too. You should hear me kicking around sometimes.
Really?
Sometimes I give not only the answer, but the question, as I call the contestant.
What's the hardest thing about doing that show?
Concentrating. You must concentrate for half an hour because the show really goes one, two, three, four, back and forth, back and forth.
And a lot of things to keep track of. It's fascinating.
You know, all of your life you're indoctrinated to ask questions. And all of a sudden you are given the answer to come up with a question, and it's a mental block. It throws you. It really does.
It sure does.
But it's a thrill to be here, though.
Well, now, let's see. I'm trying to think of an answer. I'm trying to think of an answer. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Are we out of time? What is are we out of time?
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Art. We'll be back with more of What's My Line right after this message.
Play along. The Summer of Love. When did that happen?
The 60s.
Groovy. Kerouac's On the Road was published.
In the 50s, daddy-o.
Pam Grier starred in Coffee.
In the 70s. Can you dig it?
The Charleston.
The Roaring 20s.
Harrison Ford starred as Indiana Jones.
In the 80s.
Here's one our viewers should know. When did that happen?
Easy. The 90s.
Weeknights, 10 Eastern, 7 Pacific, live right here on Game Show Network.
Mystic Music presents Red Hot. 35 scorching red hot hits. Fiery red hot rock songs will set your speakers ablaze. Red Hot 10 songs will set the floor on fire. Red Hot love songs will ignite your passion. Too hot to be sold in stores. So call now to get your own sizzling collection. Two cassettes for only $19.95. Two CDs, only $26.95. Here's how to order.
To order Red Hot, call 1-800-505-9911. Or send $19.95 for two cassettes or $26.95 for two CDs. Plus $4.95 shipping to Red Hot. PO Box 1144-GAME, Monument, Colorado. Or call 1-800-505-9911. That's 1-800-505-9911.
Now, Gone with the Wind can be yours on video. Bring home the passion.
You should be kissed and often by someone who knows how.
And the desire.
Despite the whole silly world going to pieces around us, I love you.
Of the screen's most enduring love story.
Kiss me once.
Frankly, my dear, I don't give a damn.
God is my witness. I'll never be hungry again.
Add the greatest romance of all time to your collection. Gone with the Wind. Now for sale on video at its lowest price ever.
Next up, you can fill in the blank with Match Game, followed by celebrities airing their secrets on Tattletales, and extreme entertainment on Extreme Gong.
You know, those shows where they deal with general knowledge, like Jeopardy, the one that Art does, must be very instructive to do. You got to learn a lot on them.
Do you learn anything on this show, do you feel, Larry?
Yeah, I think I learned some things on this show that
you learn how to get off the air on time?
No, I haven't learned that yet, which causes a lot of trouble around here sometimes. But Art's been doing that show for 9 years. He must have more facts stored up in his head than almost anybody except the Encyclopedia Britannica.
Yeah.
You know, I discovered something interesting the other day. My encyclopedia is out of time. Is out of time.
Are you?
And so are we. Oh. Goodbye, everybody. We'll see you tomorrow.
This is Chet Gould speaking for What's My Line, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program program was recorded.
Game Show Network. All play, all day.